Hey, good morning, everybody. I hope you had so much fun with our activity yesterday with doing random acts of kindness. I'm so curious to hear what you did for your act and who you did it for. I really had so much fun surprising Miss Shahan, and I hope it made her day because it made mine. I know that sometimes whenever you do something good for someone else, you make them happy, and then that makes you happy. So it's just this like whole cycle of happiness that starts like with you doing something good. So it was a good feeling. Let's dive into our calendar for today. We are still in the month of April, and today is April 16th. It's a Thursday. April 16th. So we're almost through with one more week. I can't believe it. It really feels like it's going by so fast. So today I'm going to draw a diamond shape. There we go. Now today I have a book that I'm going to read to you, and I kind of thought we could go outside because it is so nice out today. I hope you guys get to do something outside this morning or even this afternoon. I know I will too. So here I am at the yard, and I thought I would switch it up a little bit and read the book to you out here. So the book I'm reading to you today is Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day by Judith Viorst. I would also like to say that I have permission to read this book from Sourcebooks. So Sourcebooks, thank you for allowing me to read this online to my class. Back to the book, guys. I went to sleep with gum in my mouth, and now there's gum in my hair. And when I got out of bed this morning, I tripped on the skateboard, and by mistake, I dropped my sweater in the sink while the water was running, and I could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. At breakfast, Anthony found a Corvette Stingray car kit in his breakfast cereal box, and Nick found a Junior Undercover Agent code ring in his breakfast cereal box. But in my breakfast cereal box, all I found was breakfast cereal. I think I'll move to Australia. In the carpool, Mrs. Gibson let Becky have a seat by the window. Aubrey and Elliot got seats by the window, too. I said I was being scrunched. I said I was being smushed. I said if I don't get a seat by the window, I'm gonna be carsick. No one even answered. I could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. At school, Mrs. Dickens liked Paul's picture of the sailboat better than my picture of the invisible castle. At singing time, she said I sang too loud. At counting time, she said I left out 16. Who needs 16? I could tell it was going to be a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. I wonder why she didn't like his picture of the invisible castle. I could tell because Paul said I wasn't his best friend anymore. He said that Philip Parker was his best friend, and that Albert Moyo was his next best friend, and that I was only his third best friend. I hope you sit on a tack, I said to Paul. I hope the next time you get a double-decker strawberry ice cream cone
The ice cream part falls off the cone part and lands in Australia. There were two cupcakes in Philip Parker's lunch bag, and Albert got a Hershey bar with almonds, and Paul's mother gave him a piece of jelly roll that had little coconut sprinkles on top. Guess whose mother forgot to put in dessert? It was a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. That's what it was, because after school, my mom took us all to the dentist, and Dr. Fields found a cavity just in me. Come back next week and I'll fix it, said Dr. Fields. Next week, I said, I'm going to Australia. On the way downstairs, the elevator door closed on my foot. And while we were waiting for my mom to go get the car, Anthony made me fall where it was muddy. And then when I started crying because of the mud, Nick said I was a crybaby. While I was punching Nick for saying crybaby, my mom came back with the car and scolded me for being muddy and fighting. I am having a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. I told everybody, and no one even answered. So then we went to the shoe store to buy some sneakers. Anthony chose white ones with blue stripes. Nick chose red ones with white stripes. I chose blue ones with red stripes. Then the shoe man said, "We're all sold out." They made me buy plain old white ones, but they can't make me wear them. When we picked up my dad at his office, he said I couldn't play with the copying machine. But I forgot. He also said to watch out for the books on his desk, and I was careful as can be, except for my elbow. He also said, don't fool around with this phone. But I think I called Australia. My dad said, please don't pick him up anymore. It was a horrible, terrible, no good, very bad day. There were lima beans for dinner, and I hate limas. And there was kissing on TV, and I hate kissing. My bath was too hot. I got soap in my eyes. My marble went down the drain, and I had to wear my railroad train pajamas. I don't like my railroad train pajamas. When I went to bed, Nick took back the pillow he said I could keep, and the Mickey Mouse nightlight burned out, and I bit my tongue. The cat wants to sleep with Anthony and not with me. It's been a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. My mom says some days are just like that. Even in Australia. I hope you enjoyed our book, Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day by Judith Viorst. Now, have you ever had a day like Alexander? I have. Whenever you feel like nothing is going right for you and everything is going wrong. I've had those before, and honestly, those days are no fun at all. But it's how we respond to them that really matters and shows our character. I think Alexander, that book is kind of funny because it's, you can like relate, maybe some of those things have happened to you, like you go to the shoe store and they don't have your right size, or you're, everybody else is getting a prize out of their cereal box and you just get cereal, and sometimes it can really feel like that, and so it makes you, me, feel better knowing that someone else is like experiencing the same thing as me sometimes. So it makes me feel a little bit better. But today
I would like you to draw 3 different pictures from the book of bad things that happened to Alexander. So that is your assignment today, is to draw 3 things that happened to the boy in the story. And if you want, you can even caption it and say what the pictures are and what happened. Okay, everybody, I'll see you in my next video. And on Tuesday, we are taking